Every brother that's been up here, as Brother Jason said, has spoke about Christ. In one way or the other, they've pointed to Him. It's all about Him. Struggling up a hillside, up on his back he carried a heavy load. A crown of thorns was placed upon his head, and his face was all covered with blood. My heart became so heavy as I viewed this awful sight. And I thought, oh, how cruel can they be? So I ran up the hillside to help this lonely man who had fallen to the ground ahead of me. I said, friend, can I help you, oh Lord, with the burdens that you bear? The blood stain I'll freely wipe away. And then I saw the burden that he struggled to carry. And I realized he was carrying him for me. I saw it was my sins that had brought him to the ground. And I know that he carried it for me. My sin had placed the crown of thorns upon his head. But he said, I'm doing this for thee. So I fell on my knees and I cried, oh Lord, forgive me. I can see the cruel deeds I've done to thee. Then he smiled, he touched me, and he said, I've come to die on a cross that poor sinners might be free. Oh, I found a precious friend that day on Calvary. When he died upon the cross for you and me, come get acquainted with my Savior. For he died on the cross for you and me. I said, friend, can I help you with the burdens that you bear? The blood stains I freely wipe away. But then he smiled, he touched me. He said, I came to die that poor lost sinners might be free. Aren't you glad tonight that he died for the sins of the world. Oh, if you're a child of the King, you are glad of that.
Yes, sir.
When I was young, I didn't understand that. Oh, I didn't understand, Brother Kenneth, why he died, why he came. I didn't really understand things. I was young. The Bible says I was once a child, and I thought as a child. But I grew up, and I put away childish things, and I become a man. And we as men, we are just men tonight. And I hope you'll pray for a moment of time. I am just a man, and I can only do what He allows me to do. And I don't know the hearts of any man here or woman, but I trust in Him. You see, He knows what you need. I don't. He knows what you stand in need of. I do know this by being a child of the King. If you don't have Him, you need Him.
Amen.
For He's the best friend I've ever found in life. Without Him, there is no life. I hope you'll pray. There's been many, many, many things that's been on my mind since I've been up, since sitting here listening to the wonderful preaching of these brethren and being under the influence of God. And I love, and Brother Jason spoke of a countenance in a man changing and a glow about him.
Amen.
And I can see that in my brethren when they're blessed. Brother Jeremiah, I pray for a moment of time, and I won't stand long. I promise you that. But I was thinking, sitting there as the brethren was so wonderful preaching about Jesus and how He done all these miracles. And last week I preached on Peter, and I was thinking last week after church, maybe I thought, Lord, did I get what I needed to get across to them? And I don't know sometimes if we get our message across sometimes or not, but it's best known unto God. And I guess it was good because I failed Him, Brother B. So I guess maybe I didn't preach it all the way out, but we got what we wanted to get, and that's the sweet feeling of the Lord. And I hope tonight that you can pray. You see, I seen Peter when he was on the porch there, and as the old man came to him, and he said, Cornelius, I guess, and he just fell down at his feet, and Peter looked at him and said, "My old man, get up, get up. I'm just a man like you." And you see, I've heard men say the vision that Peter had. They said, "See, you can eat what you want to eat." But you see, that wasn't what it was talking about, brother, at all. It wasn't the natural food that we take in our mouth. It's not what he was talking about. Peter went and told Cornelius there. He said, "I perceive. You see, I'm not even supposed to talk to you in my words, but I perceive God is no respecter person." The brother mentioned that a while ago. In every nation, he that feareth God and worketh righteous, he's found with him. He's accepted. He's pleasing God, you see. I don't know where men are tonight, but I do know one thing. Everybody all over this world that's calling on him, he gives them that angel food that Brother Jason spoke of. He gives them a little bit of bread that comes from heaven. And I read where he says, "I am the bread that came down. If a man eats of the me, he'll never die." If you got problems in your life, if you got troubles in your life, oh, try Jesus out. He's the best friend you'll ever find in life. He's the best friend I've ever found in life. I want you to understand something. Without Him, there is no life. Let's see what Jesus did then. And that comes to my mind. One day, Brother Jason was talking about the little woman there, and I hope you'll pray for a moment. I see him. He was headed somewhere, Ronnie, when the little woman found him. He was headed to a little home because a man came to him and fell at his feet. And he said, "Oh Lord, come to my house, will you, Lord? My daughter's sick, Lord. She may be dead even,
weak to bow down. Oh God, come. Oh Jesus, come. Have you ever had problems in your life and you got somewhere down out by the wayside, out by yourself, as Brother Jason said? I want to tell you this, for the glory of God, many times every Thursday or Friday I make a little journey down to Lexington. I'm always, most times by myself. I don't turn the radio on. I turn it off. I like it real quiet. I like it real where I can't even hear anything, Tony, like you. But oh, brethren, when I feel it so quiet, when I feel it no noise around, man said, Jesus, come, oh come. My little girl is in bad shape, and Jesus made his way to the house. When we find him there, he find him right there. What did he do, Brother BJ? He just went over to the little girl and he touched her. Oh, and he said, oh damsel, arise and rise. Immediately, she got up, and she was alive. She was alive. No doubt, the word went out in the street. The little girl is alive. Is alive. Bless you, dear Lord. Is that the only time? No, no, no. The first time he raised a man, he was going into a little town, and he was going at the gate, and it was called name, and the little woman was there. It was her only son. She didn't have anybody else. Her husband had died. Her little boy was there. That's all she had, Josh. And here he was gone, and Jesus looked at her as she come in the gate, and he said, oh, woman, don't cry, don't cry. Her tears, her heart was broken. Yeah. And it touched the Master. It touched the Master. Yeah. Has your cries touched the Master? Has your voice been heard in heaven's land? Oh, Tommy, yeah, raise your hand up. Yeah. And he touched her, and he touched the coffin, and he said to the little boy, Ronnie, arise, arise.
Listen, what happened, man? What happened? He got right up. Oh, man, the one night, Brother Jeremiah, on my knees, he came. I stand before you tonight.
And I can tell you tonight, I'm alive. I'm alive. How are you alive? I'm alive in Jesus. Are you alive tonight?
Heaven, sweet heaven.
Yeah. Are you alive tonight?
Yeah,
man, I'm alive. I've got bread.
tell you tonight, I'm alive. I'm alive in Jesus. He holds my life in His hands.
Palm of His hand.
He hopes tomorrow.
I'm glad He does.
Oh, Brother BJ, He was with you when you didn't even know it. You were sleeping, wasn't you? You were sleeping. They put Him out. He didn't know where He was at. But oh, guess what? Our Lord had His hand underneath you all on. He holds us in His hand. I hold Him in my heart. He holds me in His hand. I'm glad tonight, Brother B. There's no God like Him. I don't want anybody else.
The one David said,
oh, He's my leader. He's my guide. The Lord is my shepherd. He is my shepherd. And I want no other. I want no other. You know what, tonight, friends? I'll tell you what. That little boy got up. He gave him right back to his mother. Can you imagine them going home that day? Can you imagine her holding the little boy by the hand? Can you imagine her? Is she no doubt she had her boy? Maybe by her left hand. But a right one was probably raised toward heaven. Oh, thank you, God. Bless you, Lord. My little boy, you give it back to me. I see Elijah one day. And you know what? God takes care of His people, don't He? As a brother looked from a song, I want to tell you this about Elijah, just a little bit about him. Elijah, one time, he trusted in God, wouldn't he? He looked to God and he was a prophet. Man, he was a man of God. And you know what he did? God told him there's going to be a famine in the land. Ain't going to rain, Elijah. But don't worry, I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to take care of you. Brother BJ, they said you got problems. But God said, don't worry, Brother BJ. I'm taking care of you. I'm going to take care of you for a little while. Elijah went down by the brook. And he stayed right by the brook, didn't he? And here come the ravens. Brought him a little meat. Brought him a little bread. Right from heaven. As Brother Jason's was so wonderful preaching about. He brought that and he fed him there. And he already had the water. But it was time, and there was a little woman over there, over here, you see. And God works on both ends. And He knew she was a good woman, wasn't she? And Elijah, he told him to move out and go. And this little woman, as Elijah came by the gate of the city, he seen a little woman there. And she was gathering sticks, wasn't she? And he said, woman, go fix me some bread, in my words. Go fix me a little cake of bread. And she said, Lord, you don't understand. I don't even have any. I got just a little bit, enough for one little meal for me and my son. I'm gathering this wood. That's all I got. I'm going to gather it, Lord, and I'm going to go fix it. And me and my son's going to eat it, and we're going to die. But let me tell you something, friends. If you got Jesus in your heart, He'll take care of your problems. He'll take care of your troubles. Don't you never doubt it. He goes out in front of us. He's behind us. He's Alpha and Omega. Elijah, he said, go on, woman, and make it, and God will bless you.
Yeah, she did.
And you know what she did? She was obedient.
Yeah, she was.
And obedience is better than sacrifice. Yeah. She went and fixed that, and every time she went to her crib, there was always a little all that. I'll tell you what, no matter how low I get, no matter how low I slide, every time I get down, oh, there's still a little enough there. It picks me right back up and gives me strength to go on. You know what happened to this woman? Her little boy got sick too. Her little boy got sick. A lot of men don't preach that part out.
That's right.
But you know, he got sick and he died. Oh, man. She said, Lord, she said, you brought this on me. My sins have come up. My sins has called my son to die. Oh, Lord, can you see her weeping and mourning when you read that story, Brother Jerry? Oh, man, she started crying, didn't she? My sins has done this. You know what Elijah did, Matt? He picked the
little boy up, and he took him upstairs, and he laid him right in the bed there. And you know what he done? He knelt down right over top of him, Ronnie, and he started crying. Oh, mighty God. Oh, mighty God, help me, Lord. Is this what happened, Lord? Is this what happened? Yeah. Did he pray one time? Did you pray one time for something to happen and it didn't happen?
Yeah, sure.
He prayed three times over me, didn't he, Brother Benny? Oh, you can stop praying. I read where it says, pray without ceasing.
Amen.
That's what you told your little granddaughter, wasn't it? Keep on praying, honey. Yeah. He'll hear you cry. Oh, that third time Elijah but being over him, didn't he? Oh, Lord, oh, God, would you, Lord, give the breath back to this little boy, God? And you know what? All at once, what happened? The little boy got up. He got up. He was dead, but he became alive. Can you imagine the joy that went on in that house? I'll tell you how much joy went on in my house. As the brethren sang, one night on my knees, I cried mighty unto him.
Yeah.
And man, oh man, I was dead to this world. Yeah. Didn't want nothing else, Brother Jason, but him. Yeah. God, give me that life. Give me that bread, Lord. Let come, let go what may. Oh God, just give me Jesus, Lord.
Amen.
Let me feel him the rest of my days. Let me live in peace. Let me live in joy and love. But oh God, if I'm to suffer, if I'm to have problems, let it be here, Lord. Let it be here. That's my cry now. You know why? Because in the morning of all mornings, I'm going to be alive. I'm going to be alive forevermore. There's going to be joy. Oh, Sister Edda, man. This world can't contain the joy that he has laid up for us. I tell you, the best move you ever made in your life was to move toward Jesus. Because he said, if you draw nigh unto me, I'll draw nigh unto you. If you knock, it'll be open unto you, the door. I'm glad tonight that he's the leader of all leaders. He's the king of all kings. As Brother Randy said, he's Lord of lords and he's king of kings. And there's no friend like Jesus Christ. Come see a man that told me all things ever I did. Is this not Christ? Is it not Christ? Oh man, oh man. I don't know what I'd do in life anymore without him. After I've had a taste of him, I don't want anything else. Do you, Brother BJ? There's nobody else. I'm glad. If you got him in your life tonight, he gave you a commandment.
And he said, go home, put your light on the candlestick, and make it light to all that's in the house. I want to tell you something tonight. There's something about being called a child of God. There's something being called a Christian. There's something there's something about your children knowing whose side you're on, Brother BJ. And I'm glad tonight that I'm on the right side.
All the greetings, they're going to be precious by the ones we love so dear. No mortal man has ever heard what we will hear.
Welcome home.
Rejoicing in the Lord on the road. Tonight when we go to bed, He'll be there with us. And everything gets quiet.
Amen.
The Lord.